it's the first time to have something new for this particular organ. A lot's been done on the heart, the kidney, the liver, but very little has been done on the intestine and that unmet need. You
know? So what we're trying to do is save lives through providing healthy organs for transplants.
500,000 people have had some kind of intestine removed, but only like 100 people have anything put back in. I mean, that seems kind of wild. And so this idea that you have, you know, the supply and the demand, but there's no market.
And our first product is the intestinal preservation unit. So focusing on the intestine, transporting it from the donor to the recipient.
And the way that this works is the transplant surgeon would power on the box, and then it allows him or her to control the flow through each one of those pumps, and it's also recording temperature data, which it's storing on some onboard memory.
So the very first version of this prototype was designed for the intestine, but over the long term, we really need to expand to other organs and create a box for the liver, and then over the longer term for the kidney as well.
What Joe did for us was make it so all of the internal parts, as you know as well, is our...
So the four founders of Revai are myself and Jen. We're both first-year students at the Yale School of Management, as well as Dr. John Geibel, Director of Surgical Research at the Yale School of Medicine, and Dr. Joseph Zinter, who's the Assistant Director of the Center for Engineering, Innovation, and Design.
One of the other things that's going to be really important going forward is making sure that the technology we develop for the hardware can be leveraged into other applications that we talked about.
So my role in the company is really around the business side, so making sure that we're incorporated, everything's set up, we have the right team in place, and then working with other parties, so investors, partnerships.
Right now we have a working prototype that we can actually use, and we have those agreements with the organ banks to go out.
So my role is being involved heavily in the product development process.
Because the housing is up here with the mechanical stuff and the pumps.
So along with that, we're looking to get FDA approval for the device so we can get approved and get our product to market.
The biggest thing I've learned is really working in a team. So you know, you have this cross-collaboration with a lot of different stakeholders and just getting everybody on board and making sure that you're all working towards the same mission.
Everyone tells you it's going to be such a roller coaster and, you know, you have extreme highs and lows. And you say, oh, yeah, I'm okay. I can handle that.
Right.
But when you actually go through the process, you really do experience these moments of, this is never going to work. But also, we've had a great network of peers and fellow entrepreneurs who've really been able to support us where you feel like this is possible and that we'll really be able to achieve our goal of saving people's lives, which is, you know, what keeps us going, I think, at the end of the day. I don't think that I could have had this experience at any other place.